Carl had no trouble recognizing his employer. He had been killed. There was no need to be a detective to figure that out. But only a detective could have noticed that the killer had to have been very close, that the fatal blow had been given before the victim even realized. Carl was used to strange phenomena, but a chunk of ice like this, as if an iceberg came out of the ground, that was a first. The Polaroid, Carl's long-standing and faithful ally, had seen its share of husbands caught red-handed cheating. There's always something out there waiting to be snapped away. It was so cold. Already, Carl did not feel his toes anymore. The crossbow bolt stuck into the wooden stairs reminded Carl of the arrow that was said to have hit Achilles' heel. But who was the intended Achilles this time? Someone had lost a few liters of blood here. Carl's first thought had been a lumber accident, someone's hand cut by a saw, or a hunting accident. In any case, whoever had lost all this blood couldn't have gone far. Perhaps they were already dead. Another instance of this magic ice. What was this one doing, lying on the ground, so afraid? The plot thickened like water into ice. It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. The blood and the shape of the hole in the ground left no room for doubt. Someone had been buried here. Someone whose life had been taken with blunt force. Where was the body now? Right until that point, Carl had believed that the object of this crossbow hunting had been a ravenous wolf who was terrorizing the village. But as he noticed the height at which the bolts had been fired, he concluded that the beast had to have been as tall as a man on his feet, not unlike a gorilla. The thought was chilling. This hunt was never ending. Carl hoped that the hunter had finally triumphed over the beast. With this many bolts fired, the beast now had to have been pierced through and through.